I will continue the series that I started by analyzing other lifter technique. In this video, we'll speak about Ilias Ilin 242 clean and jerk. Last two videos, I was doing Toma Loredana and Clarence Kennedy snatch. This video will be about the clean and jerk. And for this video, you chose the Ilias Ilin 242 clean and jerk. So I think this one is the best video to start analysis the clean and jerk, because this was amazing lift of Ilias Ilin 242 clean and jerk for Worlds from 2014. It was a very nice competition to watch that one, because all lifter was very strong. Was that guy from Uzbekistan that was clean and jerk 239, was the Russian guy with 240, and Ilias Ilin with 242. Let's see now the lift, the clean and jerk 242.
And now it's time for this man to start once again, and as Mikaela said, the only way he can do this,
determined
world record to lift two.
This was a dynamic start.
Kilos, surely not for gold.
This one was a very solid clean and jerk. Ilias Ilin is looking very big here. He was switched from 94 to 105, and his normal was looking like it's a bulking period. Has a very big legs. Let's see the slow motion from another side. This one. Nice, definitely right leg is stronger. Was a very impressive lift here, 242 at 105 body weight. We'll start now the analysis, we'll go frame by frame, and we'll see what it's happened here in the Ilias Ilin clean and jerk. This is that I call a dynamic start, because the cameraman was not even expected to lift that happen. Yeah, Ilia was going to the barbell and was putting hands on and starting leg with the barbell. This is what I like to call it, a dynamic start. So we don't see the start, it's already with the barbell at knees. Very good position here, it's on full foot, the arms are in the very good position. It's starting the contact right at mid tight, because if you look here, we see that the barbell is touching his tights. Mid tight contact here, and the barbell is riding a bit up to the hips. It's remaining nice, with arms are straight, it's extending on tiptoes, it's not shrugging too much the shoulders, it's using more the legs than upper body. He has a nice turnover here. I like how he's using the elbows in this position to help him to switch his direction faster under the barbell here. And if you look closely, he's turned much faster the right elbow than the left one here. Right here on the bottom position was a bit out of balance. If we look, his center of gravity was a bit too much in front, and after that he was improved very well, and he was put himself in a good balance. When he's going up from the bottom, if we notice here, he's pushing all the weight on the right leg. This means his right leg is stronger, and obviously if right leg is stronger, his left arm is also stronger, and probably that's why his left arm was his left elbow was not fully turned over, because it's probably using more that arm. Here in front rack it's using a full hand position. It's not staying at all with barbell here on the chest, and after he's finished the clean, he's already started the clean and jerk. This could be from many reasons, and most of the time the main reason it's not liking to staying too much with barbell on shoulders, and probably he's not breathing properly, and he's losing his core position, and it's feeling that barbell it's crashing on him. And probably that's why it's preferring to do the jerk right after the clean. Was in a very good balance here. I like here at the dip, the elbows remaining very good. The barbell is remaining nice on the shoulders. At the dip here, the break is very nice. We see that he's using more the right leg. Not seeing very well here because in this shot I don't have a lot of frames, and it seemed that it's cutting short a bit the extension here, and he was not fully extended with the barbell. Footwork is nice. If you look here, it's barely noticed even in slow motion that the legs are touching the ground in same time. But if you look here at a better quality from hook grip, we'll see that his back foot is touching first. At the dip, we see that his right leg is extending faster on the tiptoes because it's stronger. But also what is interesting is that his left leg is turned in a bit here. He's putting in internal rotation, and the right leg is remaining more in the side in external rotation. And it's happening this one because our body is producing speed when it's in external rotation, and in internal rotation it's producing strength. Also, if you notice here, because his right leg is stronger, this means most of the time his left arm is stronger, and all the weight was shifted here on the left arm. In the recovery was pushing on the back foot because the barbell was a bit in front. Front foot was not placed at the required distance from center of gravity. I like it, his style, and I like it how his body was adapted after this big weight. Definitely Ilya Ilin was a very good technician here in the clean and jerk. Was not one of my favorite. For example, I prefer more the style of Anatoly Karpaty for 90 kilograms, was same from Russia, and I think Ilya, he was like it also, this guy Anatoly Karpaty, because he was having a poster with him in his old gym in Kazakhstan. This was the review of Ilya Ilin 242 clean and jerk. I hope you like this video. I will try to do more type of this video because I'm liking to do them, and I see on the comments on the previous video that you like to, and that it helping you to improve your form, and I will do more type of this video. Thanks for watching at this video, and we'll see in the next one.